A sparrow that's closely associated with watery places is the appropriately named swamp sparrow. They nest in a variety of different wetlands with standing shallow water, dense cover, and emergent vegetation that provides perches from which they sing their loud and persistent songs. Swamp sparrows are well adapted for life on the water. Their legs are especially long so that they can wade. They've even been observed looking underwater for prey like dragonfly larvae. A deep rufous crown patch and streaked back contrast with a gray breast that has a subtle dark spot in the center. One of the most common wintering and migrant birds in eastern North America becomes the song of the Northwoods in spring. The white-throated sparrow's pure whistle resonates from edges and openings in mixed and pine forests over a vast area of the northeastern U.S. and Canada. They have a mating structure like no other bird. Throughout their range, there are dominant individuals, both male and female, with bold white head stripes, like this one's. And there are birds with tan head stripes and duller plumage. The more aggressive white-striped birds nearly always mate with less territorial tan-striped birds. And it's been discovered that these different plumages and behaviors are associated with different chromosomes.